In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you.
And with your spirit.
I confess to Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned, in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask Blessed Mary, Ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us all our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory, Lord God, heavenly King, O God, almighty Father. Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. O God, who in this wonderful sacrament have left us a memorial of your passion, grant us, we pray, so to revere the sacred mysteries of your body and blood, that we may always experience within ourselves the fruits of your redemption. You who live and reign with God the Father in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God for ever and ever.
Amen. A reading from the book of Exodus. Moses came and told the people of all worlds of the Lord and of the ordinances. And all the people answered with one voice and said, "All the words which the Lord has spoken, we will do." And Moses wrote all the words of the Lord. And he rose early in the morning and built an altar at the foot of the mountain, and 12 pillars, according to the 12 tribes of Israel. And he sent young men of the people of Israel, who offered burnt offerings and sacrificed peace offerings of oxen to the Lord. And Moses took half of the blood and put it in basins, and half of the blood he threw against the altar. Then he took the book of the covenant and read it in the hearing of the people. And they said, "All that the Lord has spoken we will do, and we will be obedient." And Moses took the blood and threw it upon the people and said, "Behold, the blood of the covenant which the Lord has made with you in accordance with all these words." This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Responsorial Psalm. The cup of salvation I will raise. I will call on the Lord's name.
The cup of salvation
I will raise. I will call on the Lord's name. How can I repay the Lord for his goodness to me? The cup of salvation I will raise. I will call on the Lord's name. The cup of salvation I will raise. I will call on the Lord's name. O precious in the eyes of the Lord is the death of his faithful. Your servant, Lord, your servant am I. You have loosened my bonds. The cup of salvation I will raise. I will call on the Lord's name. A thanksgiving sacrifice I make. I will call on the Lord's name. My vows to the Lord I will fulfill before all his people. The cup of salvation I will raise. I will call on the Lord's name. A reading from the letter to the Hebrews. When Christ appeared as a high priest of the good things that have come, then through the greater and more perfect tent, not made with hands, that is, not of this creation, he entered once for all into the holy place, taking not the blood of goats and calves, but his own blood, thus securing an eternal redemption. For if the sprinkling of defiled persons with the blood of goats and bulls and with the ashes of a heifer sanctifies for the purification of the flesh, how much more shall the blood of Christ, who through the eternal Spirit offered himself without blemish to God, how much more will this purify your conscience from dead works to serve the living God? Therefore he is the mediator of a new covenant, so that those who are called may receive the promised eternal inheritance, since a death has occurred which redeems them from the transgressions under the first covenant. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Alleluia, alleluia. I am the living bread which has come down from heaven, says the Lord. Anyone who eats this bread will live forever. Alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
On the first day of unleavened bread, when they sacrificed the Passover lamb, the disciples said to Jesus, "Where will you have us go and prepare for you to eat the Passover?" And he sent two of his disciples and said to them, "Go into the city, and a man carrying a jar of water will meet you. Follow him, and wherever he enters, say to the householder, 'The teacher says, where is my guest room, where I am to eat the Passover with my disciples?' And he will show you a large upper room, furnished and ready. There, prepare for us." And the disciples set out and went to the city, and found it as he had told them, and they prepared the Passover. And as they were eating, he took bread, and blessed and broke it, and gave it to them, and said, "Take, this is my body." And he took a cup, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them, and they all drank of it. And he said to them, "This is my blood, the blood of the covenant, which is poured out for many. Truly I say to you, I shall not drink again of the fruit of the vine until that day when I drink it anew in the kingdom of God." And when they had sung a hymn, they went out to the Mount of Olives. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
The words of the Gospel. Today's feast, Corpus Christi, started around 1230 in Liège, in what's now Belgium. It was the result of a vision reported by a Beguine, Julienne de Cognon. And through her dogged determination and the enthusiasm of local Dominicans, Pope Urban IV, who earlier had been the Archdeacon of Liège, was persuaded in 1264 to promulgate this feast as a feast of the Universal Church, the very first in history. And he invited no less than St. Thomas Aquinas to compose the liturgy for the feast, that is, the prayers of the Mass and the Divine Office. For complicated reasons, it would be another 50 years before the feast arrived here in England. But by the end of the 14th century, it had become in this university one of the 4 days of the year, known as Dies Praedicabiles, on which sermons were preached in the university church, Great St. Mary's. Now, the custom of processing through the streets on this day with the Blessed Sacrament, still commonplace when I was a boy, has led to the feast being associated exclusively in the minds of many with the reserved sacrament, a practice, of course, that originally arose from the need to take Holy Communion to the sick. But the feast of Corpus Christi, now called Corpus et Sanguis Christi, the body and blood of Christ, has a far wider range of resonances. To begin with, it refers primarily and most obviously to the physical body of Jesus, first on earth and now in heaven, the body which was offered up on the cross for our redemption, the body that was taken down from the cross by the pious Jew Joseph of Arimathea, the body which the women came to anoint on the first day of the week, and crucially, the body to whose continuing reality the appearances of Jesus testified after his resurrection. But the Feast of Corpus Christi refers also to the mystical body of Christ, the mysterious truth first articulated by St. Paul, by which you and I are ourselves part of the body of Christ, members of his body. Not members as in members of a club, but members as in arms and legs. It was as a result of the words he heard on the road to Damascus, "Saul, Saul, why are you persecuting me?" that St. Paul became convinced of the profound truth that there is a shared identity between all Christians and Christ himself. It was this conviction which led St. Paul to say, "We, though many, are one body in Christ," which is why the Church, in its deepest reality, is the body of Christ. And of course, the Feast of Corpus Christi refers to the sacrament of the altar and the celebration of the Holy Eucharist, which the Second Vatican Council spoke of as the source and summit of Christian life, the sacrament indeed that makes the Church. And that's why St. Augustine could say that he gives us his body to make us into his body. Contrary to what usually happens when we consume food, namely, it becomes our substance, in this nourishment, we become what we consume. The miracle of the Eucharist, therefore, is not only that the bread and wine are truly changed into Christ's personal presence, but that we are changed too, both as individuals and together, becoming one body, the Church. The life afforded by bread is biological, but the life afforded by this bread from heaven is God's own life, divine and therefore eternal life. The Eucharist, in other words, effects a real communion both between us and God and among ourselves. And that's why there's an unavoidably political dimension to the Holy Eucharist, because by becoming sharers in his life, we are committed to bringing about that unity for which the human race was made, which is why St. Thomas Aquinas calls the Eucharist the sacrament of the unity of the mystical body. So this feast of Corpus Christi sums up the whole of our faith in three different but intimately related ways. First, it affirms that the Son of God truly became one of us. That's to say, he had and continues to have, even now, a true bodily existence, as we do, albeit glorified, as ours one day will be. That, of course, entails that the human body, even now, is to be reverenced and held sacred. And it follows that false and excessive asceticism is as contrary to our nature as hedonism. But it also follows that no body, just as much as nobody, is ever to be treated as a means rather than an end. Secondly, it affirms that we are quite literally incorporated into the body of Christ. And that entails that exclusivism and sectarianism of any kind, especially racism, is contrary not only to our human nature, but also to the nature of the Church. The Church is not a privileged elite of perfect people, but a pilgrim people. A pilgrim people pointed towards heaven, but meanwhile suffering all the weaknesses and defectibility of our fallen nature, in which all human beings share. And lastly, the Feast of Corpus Christi affirms that the communion with God in Christ, for which we were created, is not something that we achieve, neither through high-minded moralism nor rarefied spiritualism. No, it is a gift, given to us as all genuine gifts are given, out of love, because the gift of this one bread and one cup is Christ himself. So this feast of the body and blood of Christ testifies to all the real and inseparable presences of Christ in both time and eternity, made most explicit on earth in the celebration of the Holy Eucharist, the source and the summit of the Church's life and mission. St. Thomas Aquinas summed up our faith in the Eucharist in one of the prayers he wrote in 1264 for the liturgy, the exquisite O Sacrum Convivium. This is a holy banquet indeed, in which Christ himself is made our food. The memory of his passion is told again. Grace fills the mind and heart, and there is given to us an assurance of the glory that one day will be ours. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Let us bring before God all our needs.
Let us pray that celebrating these sacred mysteries with one heart and mind, we may show forth in our lives the unity for which Christ prayed. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Let us pray for the world, that rivalry and hatred may be set aside, so that nations may know the peace of Christ. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Let us pray for all victims of war and violence, that they may be freed from injustice and oppression. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Let us pray for our families, our friends and ourselves, that we may be granted the grace to love as Christ loves us. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Let us pray for our college and all its members, past and present, that our lives may glorify God and serve our neighbour. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Let us pray for the afflicted and the needy, the lonely and the unloved, that they may feel the love of Christ through our compassion. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Let us pray for all suffering serious illness, that they may know healing and peace. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Let us pray for all who have ended their earthly journey, remembering especially our family and friends, and all former members and benefactors of our college, in particular Monsignor Garrett Sweeney, the ninth master of the college, and Father Fabian Parmigiano, whose anniversaries occur around this time. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Let us ask Mary, the Mother of God, to pray for us.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Let us pray in silence.
Heavenly Father, giver of every gift and lover of all you have created, grant all our needs and hear all our prayers. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you. Fruit of the earth and work of human hands, it will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
by the mystery of this water and wine, may we come to share in the divinity of Christ, who humbled himself to share in our humanity. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Lord God, we ask you to receive us and be pleased with the sacrifice we offer you with humble and contrite hearts. Lord, wash away my iniquity. Cleanse me from my sins. Let us pray that our sacrifice may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy Church.
Grant your Church, O Lord, we pray, the gifts of unity and peace, whose signs are to be seen sacramentally in the offerings we here present. We ask you this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For at the Last Supper, with his apostles, establishing for the ages to come the saving memorial of the cross, he offered himself to you as the unblemished Lamb, the acceptable gift of perfect praise. Nourishing your faithful by this sacred mystery, you make them holy, so that the human race, bounded by one world, may be enlightened by one faith and united by one bond of charity. And so we approach the table of this wondrous sacrament, so that bathed in the sweetness of your grace, we may pass over to the heavenly realities here foreshadowed. Therefore, all creatures of heaven and earth sing a song in adoration, and we, with all the hosts of angels, cry out, and without end we acclaim, Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In the same way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your Church, spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope and Alan our Bishop and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honour is yours, for ever and ever. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil, and graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you." Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your Church, and graciously grant her peace and unity, in accordance with your will, you who live and reign for ever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And with your spirit.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. May this meaning in the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ bring eternal life to us who receive it. Lord Jesus Christ, Son of the living God, by the will of the Father and the work of the Holy Spirit, your death brought life to the world. By your holy body and blood, free me from all my sins and from every evil. Keep me faithful to your teaching, and never let me be parted from you. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. May the body of Christ bring me to everlasting life.
Thank you.
Let us pray. May this sacrament, O Lord, make us fervent with the fire of divine love, so that drawn always to your Son, we may learn to see him in our neighbour. We ask you this through the same Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Let us go in the peace of Christ.
Thanks be to God.